After Ganymede's 14 years and 16,000 miles of hard sailing in the Mediterranean, this is what her anchor chain looked like. Something had to be done.
This guy here, he appears to be about as old as the chain.
Well, thank you very much for that introduction. I am as old as the chain. In fact, today is my birthday.
Happy birthday, Ron.
Thank you so much. And as a kind of a birthday present for myself, what did I do? I spent over $2,000 on a new chain.
Wow!
And it's hopefully going to solve all my problems.
What do you think, Rick?
We build the chain just binds us link by link, day by day. What is that from?
It's all love.
No, that's from Scrooge.
So Ron has decided to gift this chain to the Milagro Marina here.
For art.
And they're going to use it as art.
We are off on another adventure. And we are hopefully going to make it to the south side of Cuba this time.
This will be our second effort.
This will be our second effort. But we're excited, we're pumped, we're confident. And I think, tomorrow we leave and take it a day at a time.
Rick?
You.
Do you know where we're going?
No, actually.
Well, let me ask
you. If I can't find it in the chart, how am I going to find it in real life?
We know where we're going. Do we know how to get there?
Yeah.
Hello, Margo.
Hi, Ron. Here we go. Here's a load.
All right. Is this everything?
Pretty much.
Wow.
This is for freezer.
Okay.
Because I've cooked a lot. We need to get room in the freezer.
Yeah.
Stuff for Sarah.
Okay.
Stuff for me.
Well, we're fixing a furler here that took a dance while we were gone.
That is awesome.
We're gonna get this wrapped around here and get it set up the way
it's supposed to be.
What's the mission, guys?
Food and booze.
Food and booze. And what do we got here? Whoa! Look at this racy. Who's driving? There goes my grocery cart. Poor guy. What are we doing? We're at our favorite place.
Same place.
I like this place.
This is a holy crap moment. How you doing? This man is giving me a smile here. Look, everybody's smiling. Everybody's saying hello.
He's from Hollywood.
It's Ron's birthday, and Ron's opening.
I think it is, and I don't know.
What a bag of presents. Look at this.
Mostly for drinking.
And, oh, well, that's good. That's shareable.
These are the ones they have at the
house. For the movie. Thanks, ladies.
Oh, I missed it. You got to do it again. For the movie.
Did you just say no?
No, I don't like it being on film. Anyway.
A kiss.
I don't like being on film. So, but
the kiss on film is the important one.
You look so good on film.
Good.
What do you got, Ron?
I got fear.
Be careful.
Smoke it!
Wow, that was good shit. This thing's still going.
Now blow it out.
President. Oh yeah, no, I gotta blow it out. Hey. Holy crap, that thing gets hot.
Blow it up.
Now it's out. Thank you, thank you.
Happy birthday!
Birthday over. Windlass repaired. Generator fixed and new chain aboard. Ganymede itching to be back on the open ocean. And yes, it was time to sail back to Cuba.
Rick and I have a lot of experience when it comes to raising flags for all our fans who have watched all the movies. So the main thing today is to get it right.
Rick, get flag.
Okay.
Yep. Would you like to raise the flag?
Oh. And we're verifying the star is pointing up, correct, though?
Yeah, the star is pointing up.
Oh, wow. Let me show people this. This is important. Wait, it's a multi-pointed star, and it's supposed to point up. We've been down this road once before, and I gotta say.
And so now we come to Cabo San Antonio, and we pick up the telephone, and lo and behold, what do we have, Ron?
I'm looking
We have texts.
It's from Don. He sent us another one.
We've got texts. We have a phone that works in Cuba.
And a phone that is actually coming across.
Amazing.
Oh my God, I got it. Glad to hear you arrived safe.
Unbelievable.
Not more than 3 years ago, we were here speaking to Obama on camera and saying, tear down the wall, man. Come on. He did it. And not only are we able to raise our flag with pride and dignity, but the most amazing thing is my iPhone, my American iPhone, worked deliciously. America, thank God.
Actually, dishwashing is the mantra of the Western world.
It's a meditative process. Yeah. Okay. Right
wheel.
Oh God.
Old daddy's at the wheel.
Where are we off to, Rickster?
We're heading into the lagoons, deep in the lagoons.
Mangroves.
Crocodiles, hopefully big fish.
So once again, we were shut out from sailing to the south side of Cuba. This time, weather was the culprit. The forecast called for a strong northwesterly, building for the next 3 days. So we headed for cover in the mangroves called Canal de Barco.
Drop the hook right up here and back down on it this way. You're back!
My new chain is working perfectly.
We're a little worried about going hungry on this trip.
Yeah.
Rick is...
We might not, fish don't cooperate.
Well, if they see your t-shirt, they're definitely not jumping on your line. True.
And now we're being real men again. Rick is still letting me be semi-captain. It's amazing. Doug is still semi-trusting me. Semi.
You're my captain, Rudd.
You're
Someone
my
says,
captain.
Someone says, who's my captain? And it's you, then I say. You guys are from California, everything's up there anymore. You forgot how it is. But all the thing that happens is you get wet.
Rick had this theory that to really catch fish, he needed to fish in the rain. Go figure.
We found out there was going to be a northwesterly, and it was going to hit today, probably about this time, and guess what? forecast was a little early or a little late. It hit about 30 hours later, but you know what? We're on a big safe boat and a big old anchor.
It seemed that Rick's theory didn't work. He came back soaked and beaten. No fish.
You're not doing it.
He's coming right at us. He's not paying attention to what he's doing.
And Margo, God bless her, is hard work in the galley. And look at this.
A little veggie salad and to go with our chili.
The next morning was clear but windy, so we decided to head east and tuck into one of these nice little anchorages shown on the charts for the night.
How's your boat sailing, Ron?
We dropped the hook in a large bay called Ensenada de Guadiana. There was not another boat in sight, entering, leaving, or anchored. We truly had the place to ourselves.
Our destination, the only nude sunbathing beach in Cuba. You see, there's a dividing line down the middle of it for his and hers. We promise, Margo, we'll be back. We'll be back.
Huh?
How big? I hear Margo in the galley.
Yep.
Working her magic.
Yep. And we'll
have... Let's see if we can find Ron. Where's Ron? The glamorous life of cruising.
It doesn't look like anything's wrong with you.
And we have toilet problems.
As usual.
This is the real deal, guys. This is it. You know? So here we are with toilet trouble, and we'll try to fix it. Ron, the owner, he's more than just an owner, more than just a captain.
He's a sucker.
Rick's had a rough day fishing.
Three lures lost today. We've caught no fish. Three lures lost today, and a whole fishing rig, rod, reel.
And that's because you had it
gone.
You put the rod and reel on the boat, lure dangling in the water, and a fish came up and stole it.
Yeah, it was a strike, a vicious strike up on the swim step.
Typically, I use paper charts, Navionics on my iPad, and the chart plotter for navigation. And so far, my three methods of navigation has put me exactly where I needed to be. Not today.
Right. Anyway, let's stick to the first plan.
Yeah, let's go in here and get
see what it looks like.
Go from there.
So Rick is wearing the chart.
And it's doing.
Rick is wearing the chart. He was wearing the flag the other day, now he's wearing the chart. Rick's running out of clothes.
The northwestern side of Cuba is protected by an almost continuous line of barrier reefs. To continue eastward, we needed to be outside the reefs. The problem, however, was that my navigational sources were all giving me contrary routes to follow through the reefs. And when you have a boat with an 8-foot draft, one has to be on their game.
Ron's been drinking for the past hour.
Ron needs to start drinking.
The man has gone mad, I'll tell you that. There's no doubt about it.
I trust you.
The man's mad.
And then, bam, Ganymede's keel was kissing the reef. Another holy shit moment as my mind quickly conjured up images of sailboats I had seen destroyed on reefs. Fortunately, the sailing gods were smiling on us. And slowly, with all hands staring down into the clear blue water, we steered out of the coral head maze and into the open ocean. Our next anchorage was part of a small industrial town called Santa Lucia. Our navigation devices all agreed that the Santa Lucia Canal had plenty of depth. We motored into a small harbor where ships had routinely loaded sulfuric acid for shipment. We thought it might be interesting to check out the town. The reality turned out to be nothing moving other than a Cuban soldier who waved us away. We did as we were told and dropped the hook among the mangroves. The weather on the south side of Cuba had not improved, so it was decided that we'd continue east to Havana. Our friend Toby would be there, and Margot's daughter, Sara. We were carrying care packages for both of them, and Havana made an easy drop-off. The other motive was that Toby was involved in helping put together Cuba's first car rally, and thought we might want to get involved. Cars? Cuba? Wanted to hear more.
We will turn from outer sea marker, we will turn 140 degrees and go to customs dock.
Cover sight.
Good to be back, good to be back.
Smells like Cuba.
Well, here we are back in Hemingway Marina, and it's pretty phenomenal to see the explosion of boats. When we were first here 4 years ago, there might have been a total of 3 cruising boats. There are now dozens and dozens and dozens lining both sides of the fingers. And good news for the Cubans, not always good news for us, wanting to be able to just come in here and get our prime spot. But what are you going to do? Progress is progress, and I'm glad for the Cubans.
Cast away over the ocean.
The next day we met at Club Havana, a beautifully maintained beach club. After a delicious lunch on the beach and mini mojitos, we discussed the first car rally in Cuba. I loved the idea and agreed to film the event. So stand by, March 2017 we'll be back in Cuba to film the first Cuba car rally. Should be a lot of fun.
No video evidence of him being down in here.
Since our last visit to Cuba, President Obama had stopped by with his family. The American flag flew proudly at our American embassy next to the Cuban flag. And the Rolling Stones had played in Havana to a crowd estimated at over 500,000 people. So things were definitely on the upswing in Cuba, and we wanted to see some of the transformations for ourselves. We took a ride down the Malecón and saw that the renovation of many iconic Havana buildings was underway. We stopped in at Hemingway's favorite bar, the Floridita, which can now barely keep up with the tourists who are bussed in for one of its signature daiquiris. And the internet, always problematic in Cuba, now has hotspots citywide for all to use. including Cuba's future Minister of Technology. And finally, a limited edition, so they tell me, Rolling Stones t-shirt for me. We still had time to make it to the south side of Cuba. So we checked out, dropped our line, slipped out of Hemingway Marina, and headed west to begin the 26-hour downwind sail back to Cabo San Antonio.
Coming up on El Moro, or known as Club,
those who really want to know
Club San Antonio.
Well, the third skill of the fish we cooked, finally we got the heat right. Nice, toasty, brown.
Oh, look at this.
Fresh. Not overcooked, a little bit of dill, a little pepper.
A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
Determined to finally get ourselves to the south side of Cuba, we left early in the morning, rounded Cabo San Antonio, turned east, and headed for Maria La Gorda, situated on the east side of Bahia de Corinthians. I grabbed the GoPro to see the new anchor chain at work, and while at it, check out damage to keel from hitting coral head.
Second week of my birthday month.
Yes.
And I'm grateful that Margo is already planning my peanut butter cookie for 69th birthday.
69th birthday? That's a year away.
I'm just ad recording.
We don't give a rat's ass. Say it's suicide.
It was time to sail back to Mexico. All of us aboard had real-life situations that needed to be dealt with back at home. So with a couple of hitchhikers aboard, we crossed the Gulf Stream again and concluded our adventure back on the island of Isla Mujeres. Thank you for watching.
How much did you get for the chain, Ron?
Well, I didn't get a big price. I negotiated down to zero.
Excellent.